दिस इज़ द टेबल इन विच इट इज़ रिटन दैट द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन डिफरेंट मीडियम्स वी हैव टू रिमेंबर ओनली द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन वैक्यूम दैट इज 3×10⁸ मीटर पर सेकेंड एंड ऑब्जर्व द अदर स्पीड यू कैन सी दैट वैन द ऑप्टिकल डेंसिटी ऑफ द मीडियम इंक्रीजिज द लाइट स्पीड इज डिक्रीजिज सो वी हैव टू इंट्रोड्यूस द न्यू टर्म विच इज न्यू टर्म दिस न्यू टर्म इज अ रेशियो ऑफ द स्पीड्स ऑफ द लाइट इन टू मीडियम्स एंड दिस टर्म इज कॉल्ड रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द टर्म रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स विद एन एग्जाम्पल हेयर आई एम टेकिंग अ ग्लास स्लैब इन विच लाइट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम एयर टू ग्लास स्लैब Air is a optically rarer medium and glass is a optically denser medium. When light is moving from rarer to denser medium, it is bending towards the normal. Let the speed of light in air is V1 and speed of light in glass is V2. The refractive index of glass with respect to air is equals to speed of light in air that is V1 upon speed of light in medium or in glass that is V2. So refractive index is a ratio of the speed from where it is coming V1 to where it is going V2. Let's generalize the term taking glass as medium 2 and air as medium 1. So refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1 is nothing but the ratio of velocity in medium 1 to the velocity in medium 2. We have two types of refractive index. First is absolute refractive index and second is relative refractive index. In absolute refractive index, medium 1 is a vacuum and in the relative refractive index, medium 1 is other than vacuum. Why we are taking the absolute refractive index here? Because if the medium is vacuum, then the speed of light is maximum, that is 3×10⁸ meter per second. So for example, light is coming from vacuum to any medium. So refractive index of medium is nothing but velocity of light in vacuum, that is C upon V. Here the value of C is same, that is 3×10⁸ meter per second. And in the relative refractive index, refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1 is V1 by V2. Understand the term refractive index with an example. The example is like this. The absolute refractive index of glass is 2 and relative refractive index of glass with respect to water is 1.5. Now find the speed of light in water. Here see, the absolute refractive index of glass is 2 means refractive index is shown by symbol N. So Ng is given, that is C upon V. Here C is speed of light in vacuum, that is 3×10⁸ meter per second, and refractive index is given, that is 2. From here we calculate the velocity of light in glass, that is 1.5×10⁸ meter per second. Now the relative refractive index of glass with respect to water is given, that is 1.5. Now put in the formula. Relative refractive index means Ng with respect to W is equals to speed of light in water to the speed of light in glass. Here the speed of light in glass we have calculated, that is 1.5×10⁸ meter per second. Now multiply, we get 1.5×1.5 2.25×10⁸ meter per second. So the speed of light in water is 2.25×10⁸ meter per second. See the principle of the reversibility of path of light. Let it understand with an example. A light is coming from first medium to second medium. The refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium, that is N21, is equals to speed of light in first medium to the speed of light in second medium, that is V1 by V2. Now reverse the path. Reverse the path means light is going from second medium to first medium. So the refractive index of first medium with respect to the second medium, that is velocity of light in second medium to the velocity of light in first medium. Now multiply these equations. In the right side we cancel each and everything, and here we get refractive index n21 into n12 equals to 1, and here we get n21 is equals to 1 by 2 n12. It means that the refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1 is nothing but the reciprocal of the refractive index of medium 1 with respect to medium 2. Let's derive the relationship between the absolute refractive index and relative refractive index. I am taking the same example in which light is coming from first medium to second medium. The refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium, that is V1 by V2. Now see the absolute refractive index. Absolute refractive index of first medium N1 is nothing but C upon V1, and absolute refractive index of second medium is nothing but C upon V2. Here C is a speed of light in vacuum, that is 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second, which is constant value. And V2 is the velocity of light in medium 2, and V1 is velocity of light in medium 1. Now calculate the value of V1 and V2 from this expression, that is here V1 become C upon N1 and V2 become C upon N2. Now put the value in the first equation. Here we get refractive index after cancellation, the relative refractive index, that is N21, is equals to N2 by N1. It means relative refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1 is nothing but the absolute refractive index of medium 2 upon absolute refractive index of medium 1. See the relationship between the relative refractive index and wavelength. Here see one thing, that first of all we have to see the relationship between the velocity and the wavelength. We know that speed is equals to distance upon time. Here distance is nothing but a length of a wave, that is wavelength. It is represented by a symbol lambda. And 1 upon t is nothing but a frequency. So our velocity become lambda into frequency. Here frequency is depend upon the source of the light. So if the source of the light is same, then the frequency is same irrespective of any other medium. So here V1 become lambda 1 into F and V2 become lambda 2 into F. Now substitute the value in the relative refractive index, that is N21 is equals to V1 by V2. FF is cancelled and we get relative refractive index equals to lambda 1 upon lambda 2. Similar to reflection, we have a refraction in which incident ray is striking at the boundary of two mediums, medium 1 and medium 2. Here suppose medium 2 is optically denser than medium 1. So the light ray is bending towards the normal and this ray become refracted ray. Now draw the normal at a point of intersection at the boundary. Now the angle between the incident ray and the normal is called angle of incidence, and the angle between the refracted ray and the normal become angle of refraction. Now here are two laws. First law is incident ray, refracted ray and normal lies on the same plane. And second law is sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction give a constant value, and this constant value is nothing but a refractive index. And this whole law, this second law, is nothing but a Snell's law. See one example related to the refraction of light, means second law of refraction of light. The example is like this. The diagram is given in this figure. First of all, see the diagram, and in this question, it is asked to find the refractive index of medium 2. We know that the refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1 is nothing but sin I upon sin R. Here angle 30 is given with the boundary. We have to take the angle of incidence with the normal. So its hole become 90 degree, so angle of incidence become 60 degree, and angle of refraction is given with normal, that is with refracted ray and normal ray, that is 45 degree. Now put the values, sin I upon sin r is equals to mu, or that is refractive index n, 2 with respect to 1 medium. Here sin I means sin 60 degree upon sin 45 degree. Sin 60 value we know that under root 3 by 2, and sin 45 is 1 by under root 2. After solving we get under root 6 by 2, and this value is numerically approximately 1.22. So the refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1 is nothing but 1.22.